Hello, thank you for joining the Texas Instruments new product update webinar. Just a reminder that this is a weekly series every Thursday at 10 a.m. Central. A few quick announcements before we get started. This webinar will be recorded and available online at ti.com/MPU. All phone lines will be muted, so if you have questions, please use the chat box and we will try to answer in real time, or you can contact your TI salesperson or field application engineer. Today's topic is low-cost real-time control for automotive. I will now pass it over to Osama Ahmad for introductions.
Awesome, thank you. So good morning, everyone. My name is Osama Ahmad. I'm a product marketing engineer for the C2000 real-time MCU product line here at Texas Instruments, based in Houston. Really glad to have the opportunity to talk about our latest addition to the cost-optimized entry-level portfolio, primarily geared towards automotive markets. So let's get right into it. So today we'll dive into a number of topics. Firstly, we'll start with what is real-time control as a fundamental challenge we see in the industry today across many different applications and kind of why it's relevant for the C2000 real-time MCU family. Then we'll dive into the highlight of the day, which is the F280015x newest low-cost MCU family and how it fits within the scalable C2000 portfolio. We'll also talk about the different hardware, software, and web-based tools that allows developers to go to production faster than ever. And I'll also highlight our latest automotive HVAC reference design targeted for e-compressor applications, which is on ti.com today and is supported by the cost-optimized F280015x MCU family. And then lastly, we'll just close with resources to various links and how you can learn more and easily get started with the tools and products that we talk about today. Okay, so what does real-time control really mean? In the simplest terms, it consists of the steps from sensing some outside value, performing some kind of calculation, and then actuating your control system. Within the real-time signal chain, these are the steps from triggering the ADC interrupt to writing the PWM value. And the time this process takes is typically referred to as the real-time control latency. The reason this is critical is because, you know, developers can enable their applications to do more in less time, which is basically increasing the control performance of their system. There are many applications across different sectors and industries that rely heavily on real-time control performance, from automotive powertrain to body and lighting to the industrial side in motor drives, appliance, robotics, to grid infrastructure, power delivery, and applications like solar, EV charging stations, server PSUs, and more. So as we'll see in the coming slides, we'll take a look at the spec and feature list of the latest F280015x family. Optimizing this real-time control signal chain continues to be the bread and butter and kind of key market differentiator for the C2000 real-time MCU portfolio. So these are some of the key pillars of the C2000 real-time MCU offering. First and foremost, it is a scalable platform that developers can rely on to meet low, mid, high, and application requirements at various price points, feature sets, performance, and more. And like I emphasized before, we want to continue to innovate on the front of real-time signal chain performance, especially standing out with GaN and silicon carbide-based applications today. We've been in the market for more than 25 years now, so there is the needed expertise in-house to create and release hardware and software application-targeted reference designs that allow customers to go into production faster. To date, we have shipped over a billion MCUs in automotive and industrial markets to over 1,000 customers across the globe. High quality with high volume delivery through multiple fabs across the globe, really to give customers confidence in being able to support their demand needs, which we know is a hot topic as of late. Okay. So diving into the new F280015x MCU family, this is a few of the public portfolio from entry performance up to 150 MIPS of control performance to mid performance, which is 150 to 600 MIPS, up to high performance, which is over 600 MIPS. All of these MCU families that you see here today are in production, with the exception of the F280015x, and will be in production for many, many years to come. So for the F280015x, as you can see, it is the latest in the Gen 3 C2000 portfolio, joining F280002x on the entry performance families, and on the mid performance side, the F280003x and 4x families. The F280015x is a 120 megahertz or a 120 MIPS device, up to 256 KB of flash memory, with a 1KU price starting at just 99 cents, and offers 80, 64, 48, and 32 pin package options. There are some comments I've added here on the comparison of these compatible families versus the F280015X. So with the F280004X, this has a lower core performance, but does have the CLA accelerator, which really gives it a higher total MIPS performance of 200 MIPS. It also has more RAM, AEC, and other peripherals, and also has a 100-pin option. The F280003X also has a 100-pin option and has more flash versus the F280015X. And finally, the F280002X has actually less performance in memory, but has other peripherals like the FSI, which is the proprietary fast serial interface, and the configurable logic block, the CLB. So just to give kind of a picture of the comparison between the some of the entry performance and mid performance families that are highly compatible on the Gen 3 side. We looked at some of these earlier, but here's a more extensive list of the markets and applications where the performance, feature set, and price point of the F280015X MCU family has been a strong fit. Really, the primary target market for this family will be within automotive body, like HVAC, small motors, DC-AC inverters, and other body motor applications. Secondarily, we've seen momentum in the HEV EV powertrain space, like within cost-sensitive onboard charger, OBCs, or DC-DC converter applications. We've also seen positive feedback from the market on using this family as a companion MCU for safety or other functions in the powertrain space, mainly because of its cost competitiveness. And then other automotive applications include any kind of low-cost LiDAR, BMS, two or three wheeler motor control, or other low cost digital power applications. On the industrial side, in both motor control and digital power applications, there's a strong fit in appliance, HVAC, UPS, solar DC optimizer, and others as well. And of course, we know, you know, many of these applications are developed as platforms by our customer base. So the message here isn't necessarily that F280015X is the only C2000 MCU family that could fit. There are other families within the C2000 portfolio that could fit as well, like the F280003X we were looking at earlier, depending on the needs. So again, kind of pushing home that story of compatibility and scalability. All right, getting into the details of the F280015X, like I mentioned before, this device will start at 99 cents 1KU on TI.com, which will be visible when we go to production later this year, and will be produced in the TI-owned fab called LFAB later this year as well. So from a feature set perspective, this device family supports a 120 megahertz C28 DSP core, which is lockstep. Also supports floating point for floating point calculations, as well as the TMU, which is the trigonometric math unit, which is basically a hardware accelerator that handles trig functions for faster processing. Supports two ADC modules up to 21 channels. From a safety standpoint, I mentioned the lockstep core, which enables a much smoother path to ASIL B functional safety without much CPU overhead. It also supports parity memory, windowed watchdog, and we also will support different safety software and collaterals like safety manuals and FMEDAs, et cetera. From a security standpoint, this device supports dual zone security, unique ID, secure boot, JTAG lock, CMAC keys for AES. So some of the basic security enablers there. The device also supports up to 14 PWM channels, with four of those being high resolution PWM. So we're talking up to 150 picoseconds of resolution there. And then from a connectivity option standpoint, this device supports CAN-FD, CAN, ITC, SPI, UART. And from a package and pin count perspective, the 32QFN is our new smallest package targeting some of the size sensitive applications that are out there. And the remaining packages, the 48, 64, and 80 are QFP that are highly compatible with our other MCU families. There's also a grade zero option in the 48 QFP package that enables high temperature applications up to 150 degrees C ambient. Overall, basically what we've done with this is keep the spec at a minimum to make sure we're targeting the right applications while pretty much scrapping the rest of the performance and feature set to make sure we're competitive on the cost front. All right. So again, here showcasing the scalability and compatibility of the C2000 entry mid performance portfolio. I won't go through these tables line by line, but you can find the specific packages that overlap, as well as the spec comparison here of the F280015x, 2x, and 3x. From a timeline perspective, we are already providing engineering samples on TI.com today for purchase, and we are looking forward to production in July of this year for the F280015x. Okay, switching gears a bit, this is an overview of what the rapid development flow looks like with C2000. So just to run through these steps briefly, firstly, we'll be finding the right device in EVM, which can simply be done on TI.com product pages and the sysconfig tool, which is basically a graphical device / EVM configuration tool that supports pin mux, peripheral initialization, and some other functions. We also have cloud-based evaluation and free IDEs for users to start code development without any kind of downloading of software up front. There are device and application-specific software development kits which allow configuring peripherals or adding different libraries that would be relevant for the application. And finally, we do have the C2000 Academy, which is all online and free. It includes basically a self-paced academy with different software examples and, you know, tons of modular training videos to get ramped onto C2000. And again, touching on the getting started front here, this slide is a bit wordy and I've touched on much of this already, but just what I want to highlight here are the various software development kits or SDKs that are on TI.com for free for new and existing customers to start development with. This includes the C2000ware, which are essentially low-level examples and libraries, and also includes application-specific software packages within digital power and motor control applications. So we have the digital power SDK, as well as the motor control SDK, which support, application libraries, different reference designs, and more. And lastly, like I mentioned earlier, safety software supporting most of our newer Gen 3 portfolio, and that includes different self-test libraries, safety diagnostic libraries, and more. Okay, so this is the TIDM 2012, which is a reference design targeting HVAC e-compressor applications. We know with the continued, worldwide growth of HEVs and EVs, now more than ever, automotive developers are innovating to stay ahead of the game. For some context behind this reference design, for decades, the ICE engine, the internal combustion engine cars, have run their HVAC systems. In EVs and HEVs, the size or even the absence of these engines requires the introduction of different components that play a key role in HVAC systems. And one of those is a brushless DC motor or BLDC motor to rotate the AC compressor instead of the engine doing so. So along with the growth of EVs and HEVs, the HVAC compressor market is growing really side by side. So there are some key design challenges within this e-compressor application, which we have addressed with this reference design, from performance, scalability, cost, safety. So some, you know, I won't go through the features and benefits line by line here, but really high startup torque, high efficiency, you know, low audible noise are the primary features in market-leading e-compressor systems from a performance standpoint. On the cost standpoint, this is supported by the F280015x cost-optimized device that we've been talking about, as well as the mid-performance F280003x C2000 family as well. So again, kind of a scalable reference design that supports multiple MCUs within the C2000 family. And then on the safety front, this is, you know, ASIL B based reference design is based on our ASIL B and MCUs. And then we do have plans to, you know, port this reference design over to our roadmap devices, which will support ASIL D and beyond. And here you can find the video of the reference design in action, as well as a link to the control card EVM that is supported on this reference design. So really in closing, here's a table of some key resources based on content type. If you're looking for products and samples, different development tools, reference design resources, training, and other collateral. So this is kind of a care package to get started. And like was mentioned earlier, you can also, of course, contact your TI sales representative for any further information or to follow up with myself and the C2000 automotive product line. So again, yeah, this kind of wraps up the highlights of what I wanted to cover today in the NPU. Thanks for the time again. And I think we do have about 10 minutes or so for any questions that may have come in. So I'm trying to pull up the chat on my side. One second here.
Yeah, Osama, we had a question in the chat that read, where is LFAB located?
Okay. I'm able to see it now. I guess I had to stop sharing my screen here, but LFAB is located in Lehi, Utah. I see Jacob had covered that. Thanks. Kelly, are you seeing any other questions that I may not be able to see on my side?
I do not. I think that was about it. So thank you so much. Thank you so much. I think that was great. All right. Thank you, everyone, for attending today's MPU webinar. The recording and PDF version of the slides will be available at ti.com/MPU. See you next week for our next topic, learn more about TI's IWRL6432, low power 60 gigahertz mmWave radar sensor. Thank you and have a great day.